It's the soft close that everyone seems to like. No matter what you do with the box, the soft close is the seems to be the highlight of it, which is fantastic. It's American black walnut. So the box is made from American black, and the front is an American black burr. And the burr is made up of four segments pieced together to make the one. So you can see the book match folds open and open again. The whole thing is laminated out of about six sections. And the reason it's laminated is to get stability. With a lot of larger boards and larger materials, as soon as you make it from a solid piece of timber, you're likely to have movement, and especially in a box which is exposed to, you know, various humidities. It will get damp, it will get wet. Movement is the last thing you want, as the box just won't open. So for me, I'm a bespoke furniture maker by trade. The gun market is something which I'm moving into, and I wanted to show off my craftsmanship as opposed to just creating a box, which this piece is form over function, really. It's designed to catch the eye and really add a bit of interest to the vehicle. I now have an idea in my head of what I think is the perfect box. So for me, I wanted 10 flutes, I wanted 10 tumblers, storage for champagne and a few other drinks. And most of the boxes I build, the guns are broken down and strapped inside of a drawer. Now for me, I think that looks great and visually it's fantastic, but I wanted a box where I could break my gun down and then take it back into the house, clean it up without having to put it together, pull it apart every time. You know, if I was going for dinner, this box locks up, I can take the box away and put it into the safe in the hotel, or bring it with me to the restaurant in components. And so for me, the idea of having a box in the back which takes a pair of broken down guns was the perfect situation. So as long as we have the 10 of each glass, the drinks, some general accessory storage in the front, which as you can see isn't filled up, but for headphones, glasses, anything else which you might have, and the gun, we have it all in there, really.
Somebody did call shooting an armed drinks party, didn't they?
It pretty much is, yeah. It's that's the, no matter what, any of the boxes I do, the hospitality is the most exciting point for a lot of people. And the boxes do also go for people that race, so for the open boot days at you know, the horse races, people love these boxes. So without the guns in the back, we do, the insides are all interchangeable. So if you were, people do have them for picnic sets, for going for lunches, for, you know, lunch out in the park. So it's nice to be able to use the box all year round, as well as just the shooting season.
Being a cabinet maker and back in his workshop, Blake also has tips for how to look after the wood on your gun stock.
Depending on how bad the finish is on your gun, but the gun that I've got today, my gun, is pretty good. It's just had a few scratches from the odd hedgerow that we've jumped through. So hopefully a 320 grit. If it is in a much worse condition, you need to start at something like a 120, just gently, and then working down through 120, 150, 180. But the main thing with sand is to make sure that you work through those grits in small increments. Basically using every grit that you've got to get that finish. If you jump from, say, a 120 to a 180, the 180 won't sand out the scratches you've had. The 320 is the sandpaper, that's the highest grit, and then with the 4-0 wire wool. The most important thing to do is to make sure that you do use that sanding block in the first instance, and that you don't leave an uneven finish. You want to make sure that there's no grease on the gun, so the gun will pick up obviously a lot of grease and oil from you know, the human hand. You see it anywhere in a car where you've been using it for a period of time, it picks up that grease. And on the gun stock, you probably wouldn't necessarily see it. And if you didn't remove all of that grease, the finish wouldn't then take to the existing, to the stock itself. It would lift, and then the finishes can bubble and crack. And the other really important thing to do with the oil is to make sure you apply a thin layer, so build up. So on the gun boxes, they're sort of between 6 and 8 coats, depending on, it could be 5 coats if the finish is going well. But the main thing is to make sure you apply thin layer after thin layer after thin layer, because if you apply a thick layer, especially with an oil, it will, you'll be able to sort of drag your finger through the lines in it. It's really important that you do a thin layer at a time. Don't be disgruntled if at the first coat it's not necessarily going the right way. Just rub it back again gently and apply another finish. The nice thing with an oiled finish is it's not the end of the world if the finish doesn't go right. Leave it, make sure it dries, and cut it back and work it through again. Obviously, mask up all of the metalwork on the gun, because usually with metalwork you can then clean it off afterwards if there is any overspill of oil. Make sure you use a high quality masking tape, something that doesn't allow what they call bleed through. So a cheap tape, the oil will bleed through the masking tape. So something everyone knows, frog tape, which is what you use, you know, in your decorating your home, you use the big green masking tape. It's worth spending a couple of pounds on some masking tape, because it will protect the rest of your gun. Now, oil is better than something like a varnish or a lacquer, because the lacquer will sit on top of the wood as opposed to penetrating. It never really feeds it. The wood inside is still allowed to expand and contract and move. It just seals it up. It's called Rubio Monocoat. The abrasive pad So these are the pads that we use, and they're used as a floor polishing pad. So they're like a plastic webbing, I guess. And basically the idea is they have a texture so they can work the oil into the wood and make sure the oil has penetrated properly, as opposed to just with a rag, which it just, you're polishing off the oil before it's had a chance to settle in. This actually allows the oil to work in, and then you buff it off afterwards. So with a cotton rag, and make sure it's a clean, lint-free cotton rag, otherwise the lint will sit on the oil finish afterwards, and then you try and get it off, and then the finish is affected. Just a pair of cotton underpants would do the job, really. But try and use something white so that you can easily see the fibres afterwards. The darker colours you tend to miss.
Blake's gun cabinets are not cheap. They start at £4,000, and the most expensive one he made cost more than £10,000. But they are lovely. If you want to see more of them, have a look at his website, blakebespokefurniture.com.